Good clap that time. Good clap.
Well, once again, it's Friday night here, and it is very quiet right now because someone is speaking in the back. We have a three-day event going on from what Todd has told me, and it's maybe he can come and join us a little bit later. He said he might be able to.
Are they going to be here for 3 days? Three whole days?
Yeah, they're going to be here for 3 days. I don't know if it's like 72 hours.
That's going to
get
stinky.
Like the Rolex 24 race that's going on, you know, where you just race for 24 straight hours, which is actually going on right now in Daytona, I believe, or starting this weekend. But that's beside the point. Hi, my name is Art Miles. This is Greg Moen, and our guest this evening is Ricky from the Defiant Giant, if I'm not mistaken. Did I say that right?
You did. Defiant Giant Productions.
And Defiant Giant Productions. Ricky has been here before. He was here at the grand opening.
Yep.
And then you visited us for one other podcast. Is that true? One of our earlier ones.
Right.
Where we were back there in the wood table, right?
We're very experienced now. We're up to episode 75, maybe.
Wow.
Yeah. We pumped out a lot of episodes. But welcome to the show. We haven't seen you here in a while, so we're glad to have you here.
Glad to be back.
You are here to kind of let us know of a project you're working on, but also let's kind of catch up. What's been going on with you since last we saw you with your podcast?
My podcast, we're definitely making strides as far as like the direction we want to go in terms of show quality. Us being at Full Sail University and recording our shows out of there, it provides us with a lot of different opportunities. As you might recall, back in October, here in downtown Orlando, they had Orlando IX, the big technology conference.
Actually, I went there. Yeah, I went there with work.
Okay. And, you know, because we're Full Sail students, we got like a free all-access pass worth $400, and we got to go, you know, every day, and it was real awesome, and I did a lot of networking.
Why don't we get cool stuff
Did you do a podcast from there or anything?
I did not do a podcast from there, but I went there recruiting, you know, either podcast guests or other people who can help.
I wish I had. I was generously given a press pass.
Okay.
From Mark Schaub, who has been on our podcast before. He's the one who runs the Orlando Mall Guide.
Okay.
He runs the Orlando Mall Guide, and he's been on our show at the premiere as well on one other episode. But it was really cool being there because they had the Oculus Rift there. Did you try that?
No, I didn't. I didn't take advantage.
That's the new deal. This is how it's all going to be in the future. We're going to do our podcast like this in the future, I think. We're just going to have those goggles on.
Podcasts? Yeah. Like that?
Didn't you say you had a VR gear or something like that?
Me?
You were not the person I was? Okay, I wasn't talking to that person.
We talked last week on our show about how Howard Stern announced he's going to be doing something called Howard 360 soon on his show.
It was you. You said you put your phone in this thing, right?
Oh, yeah. It's like those little wooden boxes that you build.
I don't know what you're talking about. Except for
that thing that I was talking about.
Yeah, except for that exact thing we were talking about. Yeah, where you put your phone, you put your iPhone in the thing. When you load the app, it gives you two monitors and then those on your phone, and you put your phone right in the thing, and you kind of just do this.
VR is coming.
You're working on your podcast now. You're still doing the wrestling portion of your podcast?
Absolutely. That was gonna be my next point.
Yes.
We started to do incorporate more WWE superstars. Being on the show as guests, we recently had Mata Abdel Hamid, who was a competitor on Tough Enough, WWE's most recent season of Tough Enough, over the summer. We've done a couple shows with him. We did our first show, then we went on a little bit of a hiatus for a few months. Me and Steven both went through like some injuries. We both got hurt in different accidents.
Steven's been here before. He was here at the grand opening as well, I believe. He's your podcasting partner.
Yeah, he's a producer of the show, and he got hit by a car like not too long after
Wait a minute. As a pedestrian?
Yeah, as a pedestrian.
Oh, my God. What happened? My goodness.
He was walking the crosswalk, and the car didn't stop or whatever.
Was it one of the hundreds of hit and runs that I've been hearing about on the news?
They tried to hit and run, but I guess they stopped her. I don't know how it happened, but it wasn't a hit and run.
Jeez.
And it looks like he won't be at Full Sail much longer just because of like complications of
it.
He's going to be moving back home to Philadelphia.
That's awful.
Pretty soon.
Because of the accident, really?
Because of the accident.
Unfortunate.
And he couldn't be in school.
Right.
You know.
Is everything going to work out, though? I mean, is he going to be taken care of? Because, I mean, it's pretty much...
It happened back in, like, I want to say August or September, and he's still dealing with complications.
Wow, the grand opening was in June. We saw him here in June, so it happened shortly after that.
Yeah. Herniated disc and neck problems, back problems, the whole nine. Yeah.
Was he able to continue to do the podcast with you after the accident, or was it kind of
difficult? Yeah, we only recently it's January, so we only recently came back, I want to say December.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, December was like our first show was back.
Geez, so he had some stories to tell on your show.
Yeah, for sure. And, you know, we've just been lining up WWE guests. We're trying to make the most of it while he's still around.
Does wrestling have a season, or is it basically just a 12-month continual thing.
Continual.
Right. So it doesn't have an off season or
No. It's all with.
I find that interesting because these guys put their bodies through such pain and just.
It's an interesting time right now because a lot of wrestlers are out with injuries.
Yeah.
A lot of them right now.
I wonder if there's any talk of going to a season type.
No,
they like that revenue.
In the 50-year history of the business, that's never been the case.
Mm. So it's a year-round business, and that takes a toll on people for sure. And if you're a popular wrestler, they want you at all these draws. It's not like you can say, "Hey, you take these 3 months off," because you know. They rely on the bigger wrestlers. Who would be some of the bigger wrestlers right now that are probably working 12 months out of the year?
John Cena!
Who is out with injury.
Is he?
See?
Yep.
See?
He's out.
It happens.
Let me just explain how mainstream that wrestling has gotten.
Wow, that's loud.
It is very loud back there.
I was watching a morning show because that's what you do when you take your car into
a shop. And you have to sit in the lobby.
Sit in the lobby. So I was watching some morning show, and they had one of their favorite guys in, and he happened to be John Cena.
Wow.
And they're talking about John Cena getting married, and they're showing what you would normally see on a WWE show about him getting married. And I'm looking at it going, do these guys really know what's going on here? I don't know if he's actually getting married or if this is just part of the show that he's getting married.
Right.
Yeah.
But they were selling it as he was actually getting married, and they were talking. They were showing him in a two-camera thing of him proposing to somebody or something like that.
Oh, wow.
I was like, this is weird.
You want to believe that was spontaneous, however.
No, not so much.
But John Cena, would he come, like, running down the aisle when the bride comes down, and then he comes running down?
John Cena!
I don't know. they've really gone so serious with things that now, though. I mean, it's an interesting fascination that it's almost like a real sport,
and it's a multi-million dollar business for sure.
$1 billion, yeah.
And it's always been entertaining. Even when we were kids, it's always been entertaining for sure.
And I can guarantee you, in a month or two, they're just going to continually run that thing where Donald Trump goes into the ring and shaves
Vince McMahon's
hair off.
Right.
So, you know, that's going
to
get...
To remind people. Yeah, this is what your possible future president was doing.
Yeah.
They're going to make sure those clips get a lot of play. So give us an example of what some of the more recent podcasts were, that if people wanted to click on what you had done recently.
Well, first of all, explain again where you can be found.
Oh, that's good. Yeah, give us the web address or your iTunes where we could find Giant.
Find the show on iTunes at... just go on the iTunes, go under podcasts, and search Defiant Giant Radio.
Mm-hmm.
You can also go to the Defiant Giant Productions website, thebigdg.com. Mm-hmm. Find us on Facebook as Defiant Giant Productions. Instagram at TheBigDG, Twitter. If you just go to our website, TheBigDG.com, at the bottom, it's got the links to all of our social media.
And
YouTube,
we'll put those
Vimeo.
Links at the bottom of this YouTube episode, but that is the Big DG.
Well, I'm willing
to bet. TheBigDG.com.
I'm willing to bet that if you go to Google and you type in Defiant Giant
Productions,
yes.
You're probably...
Yeah.
Even if you don't do the productions, but do the productions, you're probably top three. So they're going to find you.
On the Google, yes, for sure. So since we saw you last, we like to ask this whenever our guests come on. I'm going to take a guess that you've probably seen the Star Wars movie.
Oh, that, okay.
Yeah,
Just want to know what your thoughts were on Star Wars, or how many times you've seen it, or what your theater-going experience was like. I saw it here with the new recliner chairs where your feet go up and everything. They remade the theater here. But where did you see it, and what did you think of the movie?
I saw it when I went back home over the Christmas holidays back to Louisiana.
Okay. Louisiana, all right.
I saw it in a theater out there. I liked it a lot. Pretty much got the movie I was expecting.
Yeah.
Pretty damn good. Not a repeat offender for me. Only saw it once.
Oh, okay.
Didn't really need to see it again. I could.
I felt the same way.
I'd probably pick up on some new things that I didn't pick up the first time.
Yes.
I'm open to it, but I'm not in a rush to. There are other movies. I'm trying to see as many as I can because it's Oscar season,
and it's
like kind of my jam.
I feel like I've missed out on other movies right now, and I need to see The Revenant in the theater, it sounds like.
I've seen The Revenant.
I don't
want to
see that on DVD.
Is that the one with the theater?
Leonardo DiCaprio.
Yes, the bear is going to win the Oscar. I saw that meme. Yeah,
he's not going to thank Leo.
Yeah, he's not going to thank Leo.
So I've seen The Revenant.
So that's good. You've seen some other movies.
Creed is one that I saw over the Thanksgiving break, and I want to see that one again.
Mm-hmm.
Loved the hell out of that movie. I think Stallone's going to get the Oscar.
That got some really good buzz.
It did.
He's in a good category. Supporting
Yeah, yeah.
You know, it could be solid for him, and it could be one of those where the Academy members might say, yeah, we should give that to him, even though his movie has won.
I really like what they did with that. They almost handed it over to, like, almost a new generation.
Mm-hmm. And did it in a really good way.
And maybe there will be a Creed 2.
Oh, definitely. It's already confirmed.
Yeah.
Good.
Great. Good, yeah.
Good.
So maybe that can be a new franchise, and maybe – well, I didn't see the movie, so did Stallone die in that? Did Rocky die?
Okay.
So maybe –
because I knew he was in a hospital bed, so I thought – I was thinking they were going to kill him off.
They'll do a – what did they do in Rocky 4 when they killed off –
his father, Apollo Creed.
No, Apollo Creed.
Right, Apollo Creed. Yeah, Creed's father.
Creed's father, Apollo Creed. I thought you were saying Rocky's father.
Yes. Like, no. We don't know Rocky's father.
Never?
No.
No, we never know.
Okay.
Yes, we're going to find out years later. Burgess Meredith was his father.
Abe Vigoda.
No.
Oh.
But yes, Apollo Creed killed off in Rocky IV.
Hmm.
And I'm guessing, just from the trailers I saw, that they didn't get the very attractive woman who played Apollo Creed's wife in Rocky IV, and they went with Felicia Rashad. As the wife? Is that correct?
Yes.
Apollo's wife?
Mm-hmm. Isn't that Bill Cosby's wife?
Yes.
From the
Cosby Show.
Oh.
Yes. But I don't remember the actress that played Apollo's wife, but I don't remember seeing her again.
She looked like a big actress. She was just like.
Yeah. It just would have been nice, though, if they. I hate it when people get recast.
Hmm.
Yeah, but it wouldn't. You know, something that people would miss anyway. Like, do you even know that actress's name? Do you know it? Can you name anything else she's done?
I cannot know.
And that was what.
But the thing is, she was there. That actress was there when Apollo died and he fell to the ground and the blood on the towel.
Wasn't that 30 years ago? Wouldn't she look so different now anyway?
Yes. Perhaps she looks like Felicia Rashad and everything worked out.
Maybe not even be able to recognize her if you did.
Right.
I hate recasting, though.
Yeah, I hate it, too, but sucks. I think that one is not like a big...
It didn't matter because she wasn't a major character.
To begin with.
All right. Okay.
Now, if they did recast Han Solo in the new Star Wars movie, that would be a big...
That would have been thing.
A distraction.
So, you saw Star Wars. You were happy with it.
I was.
As many people were, according to the box office numbers.
Can't wait for the next one.
Rogue One. Oh,
yeah.
I can't wait.
Later this year.
December.
Right?
Yeah, it should come out. All Star Wars movies are now December, which means we always get a Merry Christmas now for the rest of our lives.
Are we going to get one each year?
December. Yeah.
Because Rogue One is this year.
Episode eight
is December of next year.
And then, is it Boba Fett? Han Solo.
Han Solo's get his own movie first.
And then Episode 9, and then the Boba Fett in 2020.
God damn it. It's going to be Star Wars Goes to Manhattan.
Isn't it, though? And my family's the same way. We cannot wait for Thanksgiving to be over, and it's December, and we're in Christmas mode. And now every Christmas is going to be about a new Star Wars movie.
Yeah.
That's exciting.
With a different director.
With a different director, right.
So a different take.
And for Disney, it's like Star Wars in December, Marvel in the summer.
Spring, summer.
It works out good for them. Why cram those movies together, spread them out? And that was a smart move, even though people were probably a little disappointed.
Well, I wish Marvel would just do one.
What do you mean?
You're right. They always
if they could just do one per year.
Make an Avengers movie, but don't do Avengers and Ant-Man. You know, you're saying don't jam
and
just one a year.
And Deadpool.
No. Deadpool is something totally different. That's a whole different canon, right? Deadpool is not a part of the Marvel MCU.
Oh, it's not.
It's
okay.
It's owned by Fox.
Isn't it a Marvel property?
It is, but it's Fox.
It's one of those that Fox still owns.
Oh, all right.
It's kind of like they own X-Men.
Fox
still
owns X-Men, Deadpool.
There's one
Fantastic
more.
Fantastic Four.
Yeah. Good job with that, Fox.
I think Deadpool is going to be a sleeper
hit.
Just hit. It's going to destroy.
Valentine's Day weekend? What?
It's going to do better than Ant-Man.
Yeah.
And I think it's going to be just as surprising that it does as well or better than
Ant-Man.
Remember
the initial response when they said years ago they were going to make an Iron Man movie? And the thought was, that's not one of the more popular characters.
Right. Yeah.
But I don't remember that time anymore.
That was all.
Now
they knocked it out of the park, right?
They knocked it out of the park.
Same can be said for Guardians.
Guardians, you're right. The same thing. It was like, these characters are not well known. They've done that before. Like, remember when Watchmen came out? It was like, these characters are not well known. That movie did really well, but I guess not well enough for a sequel.
Not well.
Critics.
I liked it.
I loved it, too. I have it on Blu-ray.
I guess we're in the minority.
I do, too.
I don't remember the critics hating it. Maybe it just didn't make the money.
People didn't like it.
So that's when
I knew there was a lot of people that didn't like it, but I loved it.
There's a couple of reasons why people didn't like it. Well, number one, they changed the ending completely.
Oh.
And then there was a whole thing where they didn't include a large chunk of the movie that really didn't matter, but the people are mad.
The fans don't like that.
Yeah, fans are going to get pissy about anything. And then there was the pussification of some of the characters and the...
That happens.
The damsel in distressing of Silk Spectre 2 or whatever her name is.
Okay.
Because she was a much stronger character in the novel. And it was just a lot of people love that book so much. And when you goof around with things, it was like when The Shining came out. Mm. I'm sure a lot of people were like, what the fuck is this?
You're right.
This is not The Shining.
But over time. Well, the Shining is beloved.
It's absolutely a classic.
And then Stephen King went and made his own
version. Made his own miniseries.
It was good in its own right because it was more...
One of the guys from Wings was on that. Yeah. One of the main characters from Wings played the character.
He played Jack Torrance.
Yeah, Jack Torrance.
Or Jack...
Torrance. Hello, Mrs. Torrance.
It was Torrance. The actual character name in the book was something not else. It was not Jack Torrance.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I can't remember what it was.
I don't remember that either.
I don't know if he did that or not.
But so, movies, TV, we love talking about all this stuff. But
yeah,
you actually wanted to tell us a little bit about, you were working on a
film.
You're
working on a film.
We'd gotten a tweet today or from Facebook saying, hey, can you guys, want to talk about this? And immediately I sent you a text because it's been a while. Like, hey, you're working on this. You should come over here and talk to us. So tell us about your newest project working on and where we can find it. We were discussing this earlier. Is this GoFundMe or is it the other one?
It's Indiegogo.
Indiegogo.
I knew it.
There's three. There's Indiegogo, Kickstarter,
GoFundMe.
And those are like the big three that
okay.
I know.
Kickstarter is more for like products and Indiegogo is more for like
everything.
Productions and
right.
products.
Yeah.
And GoFundMe is for I need money.
For health,
give me
or
money.
College, yeah,
right.
personal reasons.
So tell us what project you're working on and where we can find your page.
So the name of the project is Starz Collide. There is a Facebook page for the movie. Just search Starz Collide on Facebook and, hit the pages section.
Starz Collide.
And it's a movie idea that came to me back in October, late October. It was like, I'm a night owl kind of guy.
So you're upright, writing one night.
No, I wasn't even writing. I was just doing other stuff, and I'm like, all right, I'm tired.
Is it Starz
I'm going
Collide
to bed.
Fantasy. Starz Collide.
Starz Collide based on real life, bitch.
Wait a minute. Is this the Facebook you're talking about?
Yes, this is the Facebook. It's Starz with a Z. Starz Collide.
Somebody's gonna be up your ass about that.
Probably. Yeah. I see what you're getting at. I didn't think about that.
There might be a note.
Oh, okay.
Wait, you're saying they've acquired that entire word for their movie company, Starz?
Oh, I don't know.
Ricky
Starz Collide, right?
Okay, good. You found
that's
it. That's
you?
Him?
That's my page. I changed the name of my
As a matter of fact, yeah, the email or the note we got today came from Ricky Starz Collide, and it was your middle name. Like, wow,
right.
Maybe he's into wrestling now. He just changed his name. He's got a wrestling name now, Starz Collide.
That might be the name of a finisher, but not my actual wrestling name.
Oh, he's going for the Starz Collide move.
Yeah, exactly.
He's seeing stars now.
So late one October night, I was just staying up late doing whatever. Decided I'd go to bed at like 4 in the morning. Went to bed,
and
the idea came to me for the movie, and I just couldn't sleep on it. I'm like, all right, I'm going to sleep on it, and in the morning, I'm going to work on it. And I've learned from prior experience, that's a terrible idea.
That is taking a huge risk.
You woke up and forgot everything.
I've done that several
times.
This
time, I got right out of bed and started writing.
Yep.
And
I've
by
heard
7
musicians
in the morning,
say, keep a pad of paper next to the bed when you do that.
By 7 o'clock, a few hours later, I had my first draft. So it's it's basically about a guy who has a choice to make. It's set up where this guy, the main character, Lincoln, he's just revealed to his best friend, Cassidy, his true feelings for her.
Okay.
And she doesn't return his feelings, and he's kind of all embarrassed and humiliated.
Been there.
And they're at a house party when it happens. So they've both been drinking, and as the night passes along, another partygoer slips something in her drink, and she passes out, and he finds her unconscious.
Been there.
And then the story is the struggle between, okay, do I do the right thing and take care of my best friend, or do I take advantage of her and take what I really want.
Okay.
So the whole movie is about his internal struggle. And there's this guy named Colin, another partygoer, who's observing this whole thing. He's just goading Lincoln on, like, you should take advantage of your friend.
Sounds like the little angel on the
guy in
Animal House.
Right,
the movie
like
Animal House.
Oh, yeah.
So it's basically that whole kind of concept.
Very interesting.
Yeah, and it's a piece about... It's a social commentary piece.
Sure.
It's a commentary about, dating culture.
Sure.
Because he gets upset with her because he feels she's put him in the friend zone.
Okay.
And that whole word, that whole concept upsets her.
Yes.
And it's just the whole story starts off with tension. And it's pretty intense.
Now, is your goal to make this a short film?
It is a short film.
Okay.
Wrote it. We've already casted.
Okay.
Abigail Klein. I casted out of UCF. I had a little difficulty casting out of Full Sail just because there wasn't enough room for me to cast the way I needed.
Okay.
It's a resource that I do have for students, but at the time they just didn't have room for me. And I'm like, well, I can't wait on these guys forever, so I'll just do it on my own.
All right. You want to let us know about your cast?
So I did entirely casting out of UCF.
All right, good.
Hit up their theater department. The guy Samuel Waters helped me out a lot. And I have Abigail Klein. She's playing Cassidy, 21 years old, local out of Orlando. Okay. Tyler Reefer, who's playing Colin, our antagonist. And then we have Orion Devine, based out of Tampa. He's coming here from Tampa.
Okay.
And he came out and auditioned, and he knocked it out of the park. So we have Abigail Klein as Cassidy, Tyler Reefer as Colin, and then Orion Devine as our main character, Lincoln. And, you know, we're all crewed up. We're looking to shoot here in the Orlando area next month around the third week of February. But, you know, our dates aren't quite set in stone yet, but it's February 18th to the 21st. We currently have our campaign going on Indiegogo.
Okay.
We're trying to raise a goal of $1,000, which is...
That's it?
All right. Yeah, right?
Oh, my gosh.
Quite reasonable, right? All right. Now, the Indiegogo page, can we just do a search for Defiant Giant, or should we do a search for Starz? What should we do if we were on Indiegogo and we needed to do a search for that?
You try just type in Starz Collide. That's the name of the project.
Okay.
S-T-A-R-Z.
With a Z. Starz Collide.
And, you know, there's a link floating around on Facebook, and we're all doing our part in spreading the word. $1,000, not a terrible
quite
amount.
Reasonable,
we can work with it. We're calling in a lot
of
favors.
That's $1,001 bills.
Yeah.
I mean, that's not too much to ask for.
$1,000 is some production's daily craft services.
Craft services table.
Yeah.
Exactly. We started the campaign, I believe, January 5th.
Okay.
And there's about, I think, 9 or 8 days left in the campaign.
Oh, really?
And,
okay, so we need to go move quickly on this.
We're at 680.
Okay, so you've
almost
gone beyond.
There.
All right, that's good.
We are almost there.
So now it's our job to kind of get you the rest of the way by spreading the word as much as we can. We'll put the link at the bottom of this episode, and on the Facebook page, we'll put it at the top of the episode so we kind of let people know why you were here today. So what was the auditioning process for you like as the writer?
Okay, so we started the audition process right around the Christmas holidays. Mm-hmm. I was actually on a bus home from Orlando, going back home to New Orleans, getting submissions, you know, emails from actors, mm-hmm. inquiring about it, and I was getting a lot of submissions.
How did you get the word out to them?
It was all Samuel Waters at the UCF Theater Department. He handled it all. He got the word out, and they just started coming to me. He's like, what's the name of your project? When are you looking to shoot? What's your email so people can contact you? And I got a whole flood. I got too many emails.
You just surround yourselves with the right people, and you can get a project done for sure.
And
are we looking at this as a purely drama, or is it a dark comedy?
It's purely a drama. Maybe a little... psychological drama.
Because I'm saying, if you would have cast Tracy Morgan as that main character, that would be hilarious comedy.
No. It's
well,
not that
I'm
kind of movie.
I'm going to get this girl pregnant.
Right.
Movie over.
And I got too many submissions.
Yeah.
So what I did was I sent everyone an email back saying, hey, can you send me a video audition?
Good.
While I'm here on break, and then people started sending me video auditions on the strength of those video submissions, you know, because I told them, okay, read this section. If you're reading for Cassidy, make sure you have a male reader. If you're reading for Lincoln, make sure you have a female reader, so on and so forth. So on the strength of those video submissions, I narrowed it down. So that way, when I came back from the Christmas break, I could just be like, you, I liked your video audition. Please come in to Full Sail this weekend so I can have you do a face-to-face audition.
How many how many video submissions did you get?
Around about 20.
You lost count.
And it's only three different parts.
That's right. Radio for a lot.
Yeah, that's a lot.
Yeah, a lot.
So the email started popping up with little paper clips on them. Like,
and you director on the project or
I
producer?
I am the writer. Producer, director, and editor.
Which is why he only needs $1,000, because he doesn't have to pay all those people.
Right.
He's that guy.
I wrote it. I'm directing it. I've been editing since high school on Avid and Adobe.
Yes,
and
Avid.
Yeah, for sure.
Get out of here.
Yeah, I've been editing on Avid for 17 years now at work and
that's
at home.
That's where I started,
I love the Avid. I love the Media Composer.
It's great.
Love it. And I can do it in my sleep. I don't have to think about editing when I edit.
What do you edit on?
Premiere.
That's good, too. I know Premiere.
Yeah. As a matter of fact.
It's because I know Avid so well, I taught myself Premiere.
Where I work, unfortunately, just to change the subject briefly, Fox Television is going to be ending their agreement with Avid that they've had for 15 years, and we're switching to Premiere next year. Some of the owned stations that are already owned by Fox, Tampa being one of them, have already made the switch. And it angers me, but I understand why, because it's expensive. Avid is an expensive product for what we use it for at work, because the whole building communicates with the software.
Right.
And I can edit Avid in my sleep, and I have to learn a whole new system, and it's frustrating to me.
You should pick it up quickly, though.
Ricky, the only reason I poop on Avid is because I have no idea how to use it.
It is complicated. I'm not going to lie. Yeah.
And but it's not.
Luckily for me, they taught us in high school. So yeah,
that's good. That is good. They taught you that in high school. Because these days it's Final Cut and Premiere they're teaching the kids.
Yeah.
Or whatever the iMovie is or whatever
is. No.
But I love my Avid, and sadly we will be losing it at work probably next year, but I'll always have it at home. I love it. Ingest, that's a problem sometimes. Like, for example, I use Greg's camera here. It's a Sony, and the chip that goes in there makes files that are not QuickTime files. So I have to convert
code.
But to plug it in and to load it into my Avid sometimes takes many hours.
Yep.
Or half a day sometimes.
Wow.
When we shoot one of these marathon shows where we're here for four hours,
it's
an all day. Or like I just put it in and go to bed. Yeah. But I'm glad you said that you added on the Avid. I'm happy to hear that. I know Kevin Smith is the same way. He shoots and he edits his dailies on his Avid the same day he shoots, so that he's always turning, turning in something.
So if you take a look at my phone here, on the right, we have Tyler, who's playing Colin, and on the left we have our Lincoln.
Okay.
That's the two. After we did
you're not going to see that.
Maybe
at all.
If you can send me that photo
right.
in that link that we started today, so I can put this photo up as we're talking about it, as I edit this on my Avid at home.
Do you have a production schedule as far as when this is going to start filming?
We're looking at February 18th through the 21st.
And nice. What cameras will you be shooting on? Just curious.
C100, Canon C100.
Nice.
Very good.
Where do you get those?
At Full Sail.
Damn it.
Rent them out.
Damn it.
Rent them out. I got to use rent them out.
I know. I mean, I can go LensPal or LensPal.
We still have to
have
money to rent, lenses from LensPal.
Oh, yeah.
Depot.
Sure.
We want to shoot anamorphic lenses.
So you'll get the camera.
Is that where a lot of your funds are going to be going to, is a rental of equipment?
Camera rental, wardrobe, because we have got to have wardrobe for the actors.
Yeah.
Securing locations. We're going to be shooting at houses in the Orlando area.
Sure.
Now, do you have the ability to rent from Full Sail because you've been there in the past, or anybody can just go and rent from Full Sail?
No.
As long as you're a student.
As long as you're a student. Right. Gotcha. And you're still a student is what you're telling me. Okay, very good.
There are two places locally in Central Florida, in Orlando area, that I know of that rents out like cameras and lenses and light kits and stuff like that. But
I
bet you get a better deal at Full Sail.
Probably, yeah.
Being a student, you probably get a really good
deal. But then again, equipment's probably rented out there a lot. Is there a waiting list for that stuff? Like you had to book it in advance?
You schedule it.
And then there's other things like securing locations and
permits. Do you have a lot of outdoor locations for what you're going to do?
Well, luckily for us, the script is, logistics-wise, it's pretty simple. It takes place all in one location. It's a house party.
Good.
Only two scenes are outdoors, and it's on a balcony and in the front porch of said house.
Good. You found those locations already?
Always a good plan to have very few outdoor scenes because weather in Orlando,
a little
not predictable.
Yeah.
And what are you keeping your locations here in Central Florida?
We're looking to shoot in the Maitland, Florida.
Maitland. That's another list. But it's Maitland.
Coast.
So we're looking to shoot in Maitland and maybe Winter Park.
And how many days will you be shooting, do you think? Do you hope?
Two, three max. Three for Feeling Froggy.
That's good. All right. It's a short film.
It is.
By the way, what is the short film? 30 minutes?
No, better not be.
No, a little bit shorter.
Yeah. Okay, good.
Not in 2 days, not in 3 days.
But maybe around 10, 15.
Now, part of this party means you're going to be dealing with audio issues. Are you going to have your characters talking and put the music in and post? Are you going to try to have music playing?
No.
Are you doing
music
in post?
Everything in post. Trying to avoid ADR as best as we can.
Right.
Working with our sound guy, but definitely have our background extras. And another thing that I'm looking to help save with the cost, we're using crew members as extras as well.
There you go.
If you're behind the camera, not doing anything important, you're in front of the camera, being an extra.
That camera's on a tripod, but then you get back in front of the camera.
Right.
We did that in our last production. Is like,
hey man, you got to do it.
Sound guy, can you just put that down? And I need you right there for just one shot.
Right.
Slate the scene.
Slate it. Put it down, and then I'll come get in the shot.
Exactly.
Is it in frame? I don't know because I'm in front of the camera now.
Right.
We'll find out later.
So
we'll check the dailies.
Any other questions? I know there's a lot of stuff I'm probably missing.
Well, no, that's good. You've got your shooting schedule. You've got your date set. You're kind of just looking for a little bit more money on the. I almost said
GoFundMe.
We're almost there. GoFundMe.
No, Indiegogo.
Damn it.
We are so close.
On the Indiegogo, you're close.
We're at $680 of our $1,000 goal, with roughly 9 days left.
Fantastic.
I think if we keep pushing and promoting, you know, it's the thing that's great, you know, it's like I had a friend of mine, my best friend from my Navy days. I woke up one morning, he alone had dropped $200.
Very nice.
And I'm like, oh, man, that's friendship. That's camaraderie right there. That's like one of the things I miss about the military, camaraderie.
Have you done any other GoFundMe projects before?
Indiegogo.
Is it Indiegogo?
It's Indiegogo.
I'm going to type that out now. Okay, thank you.
I did one back in the about this time last year. I did another one, but it was just strictly for Defiant Giant Productions as a whole.
Let's go there. Is this your first actual short film production that you're trying to put together, or have there been other?
No, this is my fourth.
Fourth? Okay.
Yeah, this is the fourth one, but this will be the first one with an actual budget, where the money to make it has not come out of my pocket. So
okay, I see.
You don't want
I did a web series pilot in Hollywood when I was living out there, and we shot at Griffith Park, where the Griffith Observatory is, and that's like a big tourist attraction.
I've been there.
Yeah, and it was like $100
just for the permit.
Hundreds of dollars. Right, yes. Just to shoot at the park for like 2 hours.
Oh.
Then you have to pay like the security guard hourly.
LA County is insane what you have to pay to just pull a camera out there.
You know what? I will say this: one of our guests that I had last month, Sheena Fowler, the head of the Orlando Film Commission.
Okay.
She was one of my guests because I met
her. She's getting beat up daily.
I mean, they do have issues here losing projects, and I guess one of the places they're losing them to now is Georgia.
Atlanta,
many things are getting done in Georgia now.
If you ever have the time, you should check out the show because it was I think it was one of the best shows we've ever done.
Sure, let me know where we can find it. Let us know.
iTunes.
iTunes and thebigdg.com, Defiant Giant Radio. And very informative show, and
is it a struggle to get work, projects here?
She's probably a liaison between the production companies and the government. And the problem
meaning, government meaning the state of Florida.
The state of Florida. The problem is the state of Florida does not care to extend tax breaks to production companies to film stuff here.
Why?
And the reason is because they don't have to.
Because of all the tourists
we
that
are
get here.
Not hurting for any money.
That's
from
a shame.
Anybody.
That's a shame because the goal was to have kind of Orlando, Central Florida be the next Hollywood all those years ago when they built
and
Disney
it's a great
studios.
Location to do it.
It is unfortunate that from a larger production perspective, it's not a great location. First of all, everything is flat. We don't have a big.
Sheena would disagree with you, man. She would.
Mount Dora.
Well, Mount Dora, I know, but we don't have a vast difference. Whereas in California, you drive an hour and you're in a desert. You drive an hour, you're in the ocean.
Sure.
You drive another hour, you're in the mountains. So I mean, there's that, and also. Beyond the Everglades, we just don't have a whole lot of land that's just sitting around. That's
empty,
a lie.
Empty
I mean,
land.
We do.
I mean, we do, but
we do,
it's
but
too far away to be
and
near a city.
11 months out of the year, it's fucking hot.
I know. So is her job a struggle for or is
Based
she like fending people
I
off?
Had with her? No.
She's doing well.
Yeah, she's,
all right.
she's doing well. And the
it's
the
politicians
are
that aren't cooperating.
Yeah.
And I think it's just because they don't feel they need to.
Okay.
There's no benefit on their end to extend those tax breaks. And they just ran out, right? I mean, we had some that I think I had just read that because I have a lot of actor friends, a lot of production friends. And
okay.
I see them on Facebook very angry about once a year about how
because they live here.
Because they live here and tax breaks aren't extended or created or whatever. And,
right.
A few of my friends have gone up to Atlanta. A couple of them have come back. A few of my friends have gone out to L.A. They all stayed out there, though.
Yeah.
So
it's
yeah,
just, it's unfortunate that it didn't become what they were hoping it would be, which was back in 1989 when I was at home in South Florida. Orlando was on the cover of Time magazine because it was going to be the next big Hollywood.
I moved here in 1982, and I had heard ever since I've lived here that this is going to become Hollywood East.
I know.
And
but when you're not even offering the simple tax breaks that that people can see on paper are going
to
make it
worth
they'll, it.
They'll go to Vancouver. They'll go to Atlanta.
Right.
They'll go
Louisiana.
To
right.
They'll
New
go
Mexico.
To
Mexico.
Yeah. I mean, when you got a film, you got to cut corners wherever you can. And if the movie's based in Florida and you can't shoot in Florida, well, so what? We're not going to do it.
We can make it look like Florida.
All right. So that's good. So last time we saw you, we were in the back corner there. And we also talked about you had mentioned a girl that you had kind of wanted to mention, and she had a
she
had an Indiegogo project or something. She was an actress, or she was somebody who had like a fascinating story about
Destiny,
her.
Oh, Destiny. Yeah.
And so, do you have any kind of update on her?
She got an AFI.
Okay.
She's still there.
That was kind of the goal, yes.
That was the goal?
She made it. Good. We had, we screened it. We had a short film, not festival, but screening series where we just screened a whole bunch of short films, and people came and they donated, and, we sold posters, and that was down in West Palm Beach.
Tell us her name again and where we could find her if we wanted to.
Destiny Thomas. I'm sure there's a lot of Destiny Thomases on Facebook.
Right,
she's
right.
not really big on social media. She's just a director.
She was trying to get to AFI. Doing,
yeah, and she got in. She
That's
made it.
Good
she's
to
still
hear that.
There.
That's good to hear
so
that.
So she's still kicking ass out there.
Awesome.
So,
That's good to hear.
Yeah,
that.
She's doing very well. I was like, what is he talking about? I don't remember this
Where
at
is
all.
He going with this girl yeah. story? Yeah. Telling a story about this girl?
But she's good.
It's not mine. It's right. not mine.
Happy ending, you know?
Oh, that's great.
What? She's still, this guy.
Yeah, I don't know. I'm drunk. I don't know. What's going on?
I'm trying to remember if we played clips of what she did, or I think I may have just put a screen grab up of her,
you might
of
have
her
did a
Indiegogo
screen, yeah.
page. I can't remember now, but that's good. She got to AFI. And have you heard any stories about her time there? Or is
she's just busy. It's crazy. It's a rigorous film school, so she's just hardcore filmmaking out there. You know, just steady busy. You know.
Well, good.
Let me go back to Starz Collide for just one second.
Okay.
What does the title mean to the story?
Maybe that's
or does it mean
that's
anything?
Maybe that's a secret.
Yeah,
it kind of
is.
No. Okay. Okay. Good.
Maybe if you read the script first, and then you can
well,
start
I don't
coming.
Want any spoilers.
No.
Well,
boy,
I guess my
sweetness. Great.
My second question is: do you need any production help, production assistance? Do you need other people involved in the project other than the crew that you've already got?
Producers.
Well, Indiegogo.
So, yeah, right. Yeah. Indiegogo, basically.
You'll get an associate producer credit.
Right. Exactly. Yeah. That's one
the
of
way
the
things
we've,
go.
Now we've got some cool perks, on the Indiegogo.
That's the way that works. If you saw the Veronica Mars movie and stayed for the credits at the end.
Oh yeah.
Whoa, man! Long. The names that popped up there
yeah.
for all the people who donated names, for that. Yeah. That's how you get into
movies.
We got
definitely some cool perks for the Indiegogo. You know, we're giving out, behind the scenes photos that are going to be taken on set of the production. As far as podcast goes, we've been recording like the table reads with the actors. We've been recording production meetings.
Oh, cool.
Like podcast style, and that'll be, it's like an exclusive podcast.
That'll
series.
Be good for the that'll Blu-ray extras one day when you put this on.
Right. It's like, it's not going to be released to like general population.
Right. No,
you have
to
donate.
To. Yeah.
Is this a story that you're, is it a production that you're considering putting it on the short film circuit?
Absolutely.
Next question. What's the next for you? Yes. After you've shot and completed.
I'm not sure what the full scope of what I'm going to do yet. I'm still focusing on pre-production and hoping that's good, and then production hoping that's good. And once we have a final cut and all that stuff, then
that'd be great at the very least to see you at the Florida Film Festival.
Exactly.
Yes.
Do you
definitely want to run a festival.
Do you see it as a story that can be developed into a full a feature?
Ah, here we go.
Yep, because not every time, but a lot of the times when people read the script, they're like, where's the rest?
Yeah,
right.
It's got to keep going because it's got a the ending to the story is very polarizing.
Okay.
People have I don't want to say liked it and disliked it. But they have mixed feelings about it. It's pretty 50-50.
Okay.
It's one of those endings where there is no right or wrong answer, and it's pretty open to interpretation.
I see.
Because, the aftermath of what happens between Lincoln and Cassie, the choice he does end up making. And what I would like to do is send you guys both the script so you can read it and let me know what you think, because I want to know what you guys think also.
See, now if I read the script, though, I don't know. Do I want to see the finished product? I hate being
everybody
spoilers
wants,
like that. Yeah.
Everybody's excited for it. That's Reddit. I don't know anybody that hates the script.
Well,
I don't know. I'm just saying I don't want it to be spoiled. I almost want to see the finished product rather than read the script.
I don't know how many films you've made, but sometimes the script doesn't necessarily mean that's what the movie's going to be.
Also,
yeah, but
if I had
read the script for Force Awakens, I would have been sad to hear page 75. What? Lightsaber through the chest. Shit.
Oh,
yeah.
Boo.
Right.
Why couldn't it have been Jar Jar?
Oh, it still could be. We can always get a flashback to that happening. Or at least get his tongue cut out.
But if you guys are open to the script, I would
gladly absolutely.
I have whenever I ask people to donate, I always say I would happily let you read the script so you know what kind of project your money's going to.
I'll throw $40 if I get a script. Yeah.
So tell me your schedule again. When do you plan on shooting?
February 18th. It looks to be the first shooting.
So you're
day.
Only 3 weeks out.
Yeah, you're pretty mm-hmm. close. I think that means you need to come back and visit with us after the shoot to let us know how the shoot went, how the editing process is going.
Yeah.
Are you going to try and shoot a little and start editing, or are you
yes.
going to finish everything?
No.
Okay,
shoot.
I like that.
Edit as we go. That way, in case I, you know, just run into any obstacles
like,
or
oh, we need
mishaps.
To go back and do this. Yeah,
exactly.
You do that in editing a lot where you're like, I wish we had done this. Oh, wait, we can do that because
yeah, exactly.
we're still shooting.
That's why I do it that way.
It's
That's
pretty good. Ambitious to try and do 16 minutes in 3 days. That's it's pretty ambitious.
Yeah.
How
I think
long?
Because the script is only 6 pages.
Oh, okay.
But,
okay.
Okay. According to my director's vision, there's going to be some things that aren't in the script
All right.
that I just have to
without,
get out.
Things without dialogue.
Right, exactly.
Okay. Oh, I got
to
assume.
Just to tell the story.
Because it's a party, it's a party location, there's going to be a little bit of room for ad lib and exposition beyond what's written on the
inserts,
page.
Inserts, you know, people sure. drinking.
All right, now I'm
so
thinking
on.
Now one of the parts of the script sounds like being in a club. Now my thought is, what kind of money are you going to spend on music on this? Are you going to try and have somebody do original music
Ooh.
For you?
I have someone doing original music, and Good. I have also gotten the rights. There's an artist out of Canada. His name's Kevy, K-E-V-V-Y.
Okay.
He's done some music, and I found him online. And I liked his music, so I reached out to the record label. They're based out of Vancouver, Canada. And ever since, you know, the Christmas holidays, I've been emailing, you know, the license, the guy to talk to about using his music
okay.
in the movie. And I've got, you know, the rights to use one of his songs, you know, as long as I don't charge, you know. I got the rights for free because I told him it's a
oh.
student production.
There are several different levels or layers of rights.
Right.
Shit, I can't remember what the thing is called.
It's confusing.
But yeah, there's levels that people put their music out for. And if you are a, let's say, not-for-profit student film, or if you're a not-for-profit
exactly.
Short film festival circuit or something like that. So there's very specific things that you can say, and then they will quote you a price.
Okay.
And usually it's somewhat reasonable. And the internet being what it is right now, there are several sites that you can go to, and there's just hundreds of
oh,
tracks.
Oh, yeah.
Hundreds.
It's
and
funny.
And
if, you,
thousands.
If you put a video together on YouTube and you want to set it to music, YouTube has a whole section of just
oh, did they
hear
have
songs
royalty
for free.
Yeah.
And huh. and your only requirement is that at the bottom of your video, you have to put the little
yeah,
thing
credit.
That says this song is so-and-so, but they're not
right.
charging anything. So I've worked on a project like that where it's like you just listen to a thousand songs and pick the one that works for you.
Unfortunately, well, a lot of times when you're producing a film, you don't have time to
right,
listen
to a thousand
hundreds
songs.
Of songs.
Well,
and,
you can type in yeah. search words. You're like, I need
you
this
can.
Type of mood or something like that. So,
but I also have an artist named Garrett Odom who's providing original music.
That's good.
And he's based
Always
out
best.
Of Atlanta? Yeah, he's based out of Atlanta.
I've got his mic on here if you want to introduce your friend yeah. here. Your driver, as
but,
you told us.
But you're going to
I'm sorry. You're more than my driver.
You introduced me as your driver, man.
Yo. It'd be better if you hold that mic closer
maybe it was
to your face.
His ride. Maybe it was what it was. His ride. Driver, maybe he didn't say driver.
This is the great Jonathan Bowens.
Hello, Jonathan.
We've
Jonathan
been
Bowens.
Since, what, September 2014?
2014.
So, yeah.
Something like that.
So he's
from 2014. You go way back.
Yeah, we go way back.
It feels like way back, man.
They met on Uber.
Okay.
No.
No, we met at Full Sail. He's a Full Sail grad.
You go to Full Sail. Very good.
Master's degree in film right here.
Sometimes.
Oh, really? You got the master's at Full Sail?
Yes.
Sometimes.
Very, very good.
I literally have a master in film.
Sometimes I literally forget how old I am. And when you say, you know, we've been friends since all the way back in 2014, I'm like, what? because I've known Art for about 25 years now. I
yeah.
mean, we met in 1990.
1993?
I wasn't even born
93?
Yet.
No,
no,
I thought
no,
it was
91. It was 91.
Yeah.
I wasn't even born yet.
25 years. Damn, 25 years.
What the hell?
And all right, so you got your film degree at Full Sail. And when did you get your degree?
This last October.
All right, this last October. How many others like graduated that? It's like
wait a minute, they constantly graduate.
Oh yeah, it's every month.
When you say a film degree, is it a specialized
master's
in something?
Film production.
Cool. Okay.
Mostly just the business side. It was all paperwork.
And I'll tell you what, man, that you can get buried in that shit because
oh, yeah.
you have to have a team of specialized people just to handle the paperwork.
Mm-hmm.
Crap part of it
yeah.
and registering with everything that you need to register with and making sure that you know if for God's sakes you have an animal on set you got to have all
oh,
the paperwork
yeah.
and all the people and
animal
it's
wrangler
it's a mess.
Same with children. I mean pretty much the same thing
yeah, yeah. when you're working with minors sure yeah.
Have you had any challenges finding work since you've gotten your degree?
Permanent work, yeah. I mean, because in film, it's pretty much just...
I don't think there is permanent work.
Yeah,
that's true.
It's project by project, mostly.
Yeah. You have projects of your own you want to work on, or you've been working on other people's projects?
Mostly other people's projects, but I do have a few scripts I have in my back pocket.
Oh, that's good. That's always good to have a few in the back pocket.
Mr. Spielberg.
Yeah, right.
Will you be working on Starz Collide?
Yes.
That's where the friendship ended.
He didn't answer right away.
You find your own way home.
I'm sure you get me in trouble.
The segment brought to you by Uber. When your friend leaves you and you need a ride.
I've worked on a few projects, and the more people you get involved, the more difficult and confusing and complicated it gets. Yeah.
More mouths to feed.
Oh, yeah.
And
I respect the fact that you're writing, producing, directing, and editing. That's generally what I do when I take on a project.
Not so much by choice, but it's right. Less people involved.
Well, yeah, mine's by choice because I'm a control freak and
right.
I can't
you don't want to have another cook in the kitchen.
Well, it's just
right.
easier for me to visualize the entire project from start to finish.
Right.
And then it's very difficult for me to take somebody else's script and then decide how I'm going to shoot that. Like, I don't know.
Right.
You tell me. You know.
Well, we kind of touched on your project you're working on. You've had your podcast that is ongoing and with some drama attached to it as well. You know?
Absolutely.
And the Indiegogo campaign is running down to what, the last 2 weeks? You say you've got
no,
2 weeks left.
We got less than 10 days.
All right, you got less than 10 days. Yeah, right. We got to turn this YouTube episode quick. Then I got to get to this Avid right now.
It'll be up on Monday.
No, we shot two today.
Oh shit! Well, just put,
I gotta go quick though.
Just
right.
Put this one first, and
right.
then
because
yeah.
That's gonna sound weird because we talked about things. All right, I just need to get them both up there quickly. So Ricky can be found on the Defiant Giant. You can find him on Facebook. You can find their podcast. Just do a search for Defiant Giant.
Now hold on a second. So you do the wrestling podcast, but do you also do a separate podcast for other stuff?
Yeah, our podcast covers wrestling, film, anime, comics.
Yeah, it's the same podcast.
Oh, okay,
yes.
okay.
Hold on. Wrestling podcast, film. Anime, comics, and movies.
Yeah, because from what it sounded like, you had like WWE guests and stuff like that. So I thought that was a separate podcast.
When I started this podcast back in LA, it was strictly movies. Then once I moved out here to Orlando, I broadened it.
Gotcha. Okay.
Gotcha. Now, is the plan for you to stay in Orlando? You know, like you want to find this as your home?
You know what? The more I explore Orlando, the more I like it.
Yeah.
This place sucks.
But you're out scouting locations cool. and stuff. You realize, hey, you know, there's a lot of opportunity here.
I think there's a lot Orlando does have to offer. And I like the fact that it's a small city. I like small cities. Mm-hmm. I usually think they're cooler.
And if you do look hard enough, you can find a lot of very cool places.
Exactly. Yeah. There's also New Orleans calling home to me also.
All right.
I've been in the military and I've been all around the world, in Japan and a whole bunch of different places, and nothing beats New Orleans to me. It's still my favorite city in the world. So
you can
walk down
the street drunk as fuck. I mean, that's a pretty cool place.
Yeah. So I'm still not sure yet, but there's valid reasons for doing pretty much anything. You know, Orlando, New Orleans, maybe even Georgia, but
yes.
I don't know.
Filmed in Georgia. What's it like when Family Feud, the Steve Harvey Family Feud that's currently on. I always see the Georgia logo come up
at
the end. Yeah.
Oh,
and he probably does his daily show there, and he probably does his radio show from there.
Probably.
Yeah. He's been very big for Georgia.
I heard he's announcing the winner of the presidency.
On the card, it said Trump. It said Trump.
Boo.
But I apologize, but okay. Hillary, and they take the sash off Trump and they put it on Hillary or something like that.
That'd be a fun day.
So one more time for the audience, let us know where they can find you and find the Indiegogo campaign.
Find the Indiegogo campaign, just go to Indiegogo.com and search Starz Collide. That's StarzCollide. Mm-hmm. And as far as all things Defiant Giant, just go to thebigdg.com, and there you will find all of the links to all of our social media, Vimeo, YouTube, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, so on and so forth, Twitch nice. Even.
And I think what I'd like you to do is after, you know, production is over and you've done shooting it, you should come on back here and give us an update so that we can kind of follow you along in this process to see
Absolutely.
How the shoot went, how the editing is going, and what your next step is after
There's
that.
There's definitely a lot of excitement
around this project. So maybe in another month or so, you could come back here on a Friday night.
Okay.
And maybe when it's all done, you could talk to Todd and have your...
have a little screening here up on the big screen or something
possibly.
Like that. Yeah.
Oh,
that's
one last thing I wanted to touch on about Starz Collide. Very important. One of the things that's been giving us trouble the past few weeks is we wanted to do a fundraising event. at some type of venue here in the Orlando area. Before we shoot, to help raise money. We were going to do like music acts and even some stand-up comics.
Well, that's a good idea.
We have people already who's agreed to do it and lined up. We just have difficulty securing an actual venue. We've reached out to the Loud Gallery in downtown, Stardust Video, and Calf Coffee.
Mm-hmm. Have you contacted the Copper Rocket? Copper Rocket.
No, never heard of it.
Look into that. Copper Rocket. They have a venue for music. It's small. Okay. It's small, but I mean, they do a lot of local type stuff.
So if you
I think that's Winter Park.
If you're watching this and you have venue ideas for Ricky on this, you know, send a message immediately on the YouTube page.
Very, very fast because they're coming down to the last couple
weeks.
We're
cutting this close.
Yeah, we've been trying to secure a place and, you know, just people. We've been sending emails to, like, owners of these venues and they haven't gotten back to us or they have. And we sent them an email and they've just been slow responding. We were thinking, you know, either charge people in advance or at the door and all that money would go to the budget.
That's good.
And then wherever we do it at, if they have a bar or some type of grill, people eat there and then the house gets that. You know, trying to work something out with the owners, and we're having difficulty with that. So there's a chance it may not happen at this point because, like I said, we've been trying for weeks. And
look into Copper Rocket because I know that they just reopened after a hiatus of being
okay. Renovations
open.
Or
and not so much renovations, a change in ownership. And I know that they're a smaller venue and they are looking for events and stuff like that. So you might want to contact
Copper
them.
Rocket.
Copper Rocket.
Okay. All right.
Well, look for us again in the near future here next week. We're trying to. No, this was me this time.
Oh, okay.
And we want Ricky to come back in a month to give us an update on his production and see how pre-production and shooting went and how the editing process is going, because we like to follow you on the path here because you're working on a local project. We want to know what's going on here locally
Absolutely.
In Orlando. Well, thank you for visiting with us.
Absolutely.
Once again, it's an Indiegogo campaign, not the other ones I was saying earlier. So look for Ricky and Starz Collide on Indiegogo, and we will see you again next week. Thanks for watching.